Well, hello there. Good night to you all. So sorry for the late post on this video, but only now I was able to return home. I got busy, very busy day. So and now I will make my review for Fairy Tale Chapter 349, called The Demon Doriarte. So, basically this chapter starts when the last one ended, with Gray being turned into his child form, and basically he still continues to use his magic. And the guy from Tartarus, he kinda does not understand why he can use it, and then Gray explains that the great big point, let's say on that way, of the ice making magic is that they need, or the fact that he was transformed into a child, it kind of forces him, or forced him, to use his imagination, because ice molding magic basically is, or one of his stronger points is basically you use your own imagination to make what the hell do you want. So that was the reason why this guy kinda was taken off guard. Then we go to the situation with Minerva and Erza, and basically Minerva was, or trashed Erza, and is kinda torturing her and such. And then suddenly she returns to his normal form. That's it, because the fact that Gray was kind of messing up with this guy, he eventually came to the realization that there are other person there that is the true responsible for freezing all the giants and all the space and all the village. And he basically called this guy from Tartarus small fry, and this kind of makes him kind of lose control, apparently. And eventually kind of turned into a monster, or a creature that is similar to the creatures of the Book of Xerath. And basically we learned that the name of this guy is Doriarte. That's kinda interesting, because then Gray kinda came to the realization that this guy is pretty similar to the monster that Ul sealed in the past, Deliora. So he's kinda wondering, or pondering, what is the connection between the secret black magic of Xerath and this guild. And apparently Xerath, it appears to me, or in the least his teachings, were a great part used, or are being used, by apparently this dark guild, Succubusai. So that kinda is interesting. Could this imply that there are other creatures like Deliora, like this guy Doriarte, that are actually alive, and they kinda take a kinda human shape, but if they lose control of their powers, or because something happens to them, they become monsters. So could this imply that there are others like Doriarte? And this also could imply that Deliora, before gaining that monster form, he was appeared kinda simply a regular human, but something happened that made him go berserk in the past. So that these are questions interesting that remain after this chapter. And then eventually, well, Erza kicks the ass of Minerva, and she's trying to reasoning with Minerva, telling her that it's not too late for Minerva to turn his back to the dark side and return to the righteous side in a way. But Minerva, I don't feel that she is very into that. Then we have a little of fan service with Minerva and Erza, as usual. And then we also have a small panel with Natsu turning into a normal guy, on in his normal form. And this chapter is quite... These last chapters were quite bad, in my opinion, for the character of Natsu, because the guy simply was running amok in the forest, and in this chapter we see that Gray, in fact, uses his brain to think a solution, but Natsu not, so it's kinda, well, that shows the difference of characters. And then, next chapter, it will be the fight between Gray in his adult form, or in his normal form, against this guy, Doriarte, and it appears that to me that it will be an interesting fight, so I'm looking forward to it. So, well, and basically that's the chapter, the questions were like the ones that I posted earlier. Could this mean that there are others like Doriarte that kind of have a human shape form, but if they lose control they kind of turn into monsters? It was that the reason why Deliora did run Rampage in the past on the north, because he kind of was living as a kind of in a humanoid shape, and then something happened and that was the reason why he did go nuts and going to Rampage. And what is the connection between Zeref, or the magic of Zeref, and this guild, Sokobuzai? They are kind of followers of Zeref. Is Zeref, let's say, the guild master of Sokobuzai? What is the story behind that? And also, what is the person that is truly responsible for freezing all time and space in this special location? Because it's heavily implying that there are a third person, that I'm kind of feeling that when Flair and Lucy and Wendy, they did go to the place where supposedly the sacred flame is, probably that person will be there or will be appearing. So that's my guessing. So that's it. This is my review for Fairy Tales 349. Hope you enjoy. Stay well. Peace. See you soon. Thanks for watching.